Welcome to M. Claire's Yoga and Wellness channel. Today we're going to do a plank challenge. So what that's going to entail is different variations of the plank. We're going to make it fun, but it will be challenging too. Not overly challenging that the regular person can't just do it. It's not for pro athletes or anything like that, but we will make it difficult so that you feel like you've had a really full body and core workout. Anyway, with that being said, let's get right on in it. If you would like to do more warming up, then please go ahead. I am going to do a moment or two, but not a lot, and then I'm going to get straight on into it. Okay, let's start in our tabletop. We're going to do some cat-cows to begin with. And just look up towards the ceiling or the sky. Tilt your tailbone. And then tuck your chin towards your chest. At your own pace. You can add any movement into this if it feels good. Then come down to your heels into child's pose. Then I want you to sink your chest in between your legs and reach your hands towards the front of your mat. Over to the left side, and then you're just going to sink your hips towards the right. Come on through the center, and then change sides. Come on to the middle, tuck your toes, come into downward facing dog. Try and reach your heels towards the floor. Sink between your hands. And then come on forward. And you're just going to move between upward facing dog and downward facing dog. And you can go at your own pace here. Like I said, we're just doing a few moments to warm up before we get on into our plank challenge. Our plank, and we're going to begin. So come forward. Make sure that your hands are underneath your shoulders. You've got a nice long flat back, and push your heels towards the floor. And we're just going to hold it here to begin with, and then we'll start to vary it up. So really engage your core. Try not to sink your hips or stick your bottom up into the air. It's really important to try and keep that nice long length. And if you start to shake, it's a good thing. It means your body's working hard. Now here we're going to come down into our forearm plank, and you're just going to hold it. Try if you can to do it all the way. If you can't, you can drop your knees and do it with your knees on the floor. Otherwise, if you need to, go into child's pose. Take a breather and then join us again. What we're going to do now is we're going to come on up and we're going to alternate between high plank and forearm plank. You don't want to rush it, you want to just go at a nice pace so you don't lose your form. Two more. Then hold again in high plank. Here, what we're going to do is bring one knee to the elbow and back. And then alternate. Roll over onto our side plank. Hold it here. You can either stack your feet or you can have them scissored apart, whichever is best for you. And if you want to change it, you can also reach your arm over your head. Come on back into high plank, and we're going to change sides. And come on back, high plank again, hold it here. Then we come back down onto our forearms, interlace your fingers, and we're going to go from dolphin to plank. Push back. You guys are doing great, keep it going. The beautiful thing about plank is you really do get a full body workout. Last five. Last two, last one, come back up into high plank, hold. Here we're going to do side taps in our high plank. So you're just going to bring your feet towards the side, however wide you can do it for your own body. Five more on each side. Last two. Last one. Come down again into your low plank. Your forearm. Roll over onto the side. Hold it here. To extend your arm over, please feel free to do so. We haven't got long, you're doing fantastic. Breathe through it. Come back. Stay on your forearms. And change sides. Come back, forearm plank, hold it here. Really make sure that core now, I know everything's burning, make sure it's engaged so you don't collapse. Then come on up, back into our high plank here, lift one leg and hold. Come back into high plank, hold it, lift your opposite leg, a few more moments here. Then come back into high plank. This is our last one. So push through it and then we're going to go into child pose. Last three breaths here. And last one. And drop your knees and come into child pose. Well done, everyone. That was tough and challenging, but I'm hoping you could feel the burn and that you can feel it all over, not just your core. Now relax for a few minutes in our child pose before we end. To just stretch it out, come on forward into your upward facing dog and just stretch out those abdominals. And if you'd like to, you can go between child pose and upward facing dog if it feels good for you. Thank you. and join me on in the center of your mat. Thank you so much for joining me for this really quick and hopefully powerful plank workout. So if you did enjoy this and you'd like to see more content just like it, please like and subscribe, and I'll make some more just like this one. Have a wonderful day. Thank you so much.